thought about two Turks. My brother was 6 years before me. He was the first Turk, and I was the second Turk. There were no other Turks in the whole school. But the first day I had my Atilla trauma, that after 5 minutes I was sitting in the class, the vice president of the school came to me and said, "Atilla, sit up." I was sitting like an alien. You have to imagine, because you are sitting, you are 11, 12, you don't have so much confidence, because we're alone from the primary school. You're sitting alone because left and right of you, nobody's sitting. In front and back, nobody's sitting. Everybody is sitting around you, and you are sitting there alone. 5 minutes later, the vice president came, "Tilda, stand up, we're going to another class." I was not saying why, I was not passing up. Grabbed my everything, was in the hall. And I said, "Well, why? I have a letter that I was on 1F. I remember that very well. There are some parents, they don't want to have Turks in the class. You are going to be placed in another class." That was my Atilla trauma. But at that moment, I promised to myself, in this country, I will go to the highest school possible. And that was Tilburg. I think I choose the right school then. Okay, when I was in Tilburg, of course, I'm just explaining it because of my generation. It was the first generation which was at school. We were first of everything. First at school, first at football, first of business. And then you get something like a second skin. It's not nice to be there at that moment. Afterward, you can tell a lot of stories about it, but at that moment, you have to struggle. But the struggle you have, you continue in your life. Because you have two choices. To be defeated or to win. And I choose to win. And not to win based on others, to win based on my own competencies. And after my academic career here, well, I think 3.5-4 years, I really wanted to be an entrepreneur. I had my dreams. And dreams were really based on, very strange, on Holland and Turkey. At that moment I was struggling, what can I do with Turkey? Did I know Turkey? No. I was, I think, 3 or 4 times with vacation with my parents, I went to Turkey, but I didn't know Turkey. I didn't know, well, I thought I knew, but after 4 vacations, are very well, it's like your first love on vacations, you really like it, etc., but it's not real. At a certain moment, I had the feeling of, I have 2 kinds of cultural DNA, and this is a positive thing, I have to do something with it, but I didn't know what exactly. But I decided at that moment, because that's when I was at university here, I started with my entrepreneurial career. I sold jeans at school, I saw tennis records, all those kind of things. I really liked it. At a certain moment, I said, I want to be an entrepreneur. But before being an entrepreneur, I first have to start with an international company. And after that, I had a planning, creative planning for myself. And after a couple of years, I will start my own company. After Tilburg, I start at the software company Baan. I don't know if anybody remembers or knows Baan. Especially the young ones, not. Baan was a very, very successful Dutch software company. In the high days, they had 12,000 employees, and they were in the top 3 of the world ERP market, the world industrial software market. A very, very big Dutch company, very successful also. Young Baan was sitting next to Bill Gates, etc., those kind of things. I was speaking about 94. Graduated in 94. The person who was sent away from the VWO. From VWO, I sent away back to the MAVO. And from the MAVO, I promised to myself I'd go to the university. And that person started with Baan. But Baan was also a very religious, Christian religious company. We were even not allowed to work on Sundays. But even at that company, that's why I respect the backbone of Holland so much, they gave me a chance. They gave me a chance to become successful. Because they say it's not your religion, but it's your output, it's your result, what we are looking for. And within 1 year, I became an international consultant, and I was married at that moment. I had always a bag in my car, because in 1 year I went to 60 different countries, because if you at 9 o'clock or 8:30 was at the company, you can read your name and a country behind it and a flight ticket. And at 11 o'clock you could go to Amsterdam flying away. And that was really a huge dream, of course. But after 6 months you have seen the same airport for the 18th time, and the same people and the stewardesses, etc., they recognize you, hey Atilla. And seeing your wife just one tenth of the time, a certain moment it's over. But at that moment, I got an opportunity. I created my opportunity, you could say. Because Baan wanted to start in Turkey, the Baan Turkey the department. Two companies from Turkey came to here, giving a presentation, because they wanted to have the sales activities of the Baan company in Turkey. And that time, those kind of Dutch companies was very regular, just to say, hey, Atilla, you are coming from Turkey, you are a Turkey expert, you go to the presentation, you choose one of them. I said, well, yeah, of course, I'm a Turkey expert. I will do it after three vacations. After the second presentation, it's like from the comic, the light came to me. They were presenting their business, the company, to get the whole sales rights. And at the second presentation, I said, wow, this is it. I will do it myself. I was 24. Right? I will do it myself. And after the presentation, I ran to the vice president and I said, Otto, I know it very well. I said, Otto, I want to go to Turkey. I want to have the sales rights and I want to build up my own company. It's like in a cup of soup, reclams. My manager said, oh, okay, easy, just cool down, just sit down. Okay, just tell me, what do you want? More money, a different car, more salary? He said, no, this is my dream. I want to do it. And afterwards, I was saying, well, they gave it to me. But afterwards, I was saying, oh, I think that's a good guy, and he is looking for an adventure. Let's give him, and 6 months later, he'll come back anyway. But I never came back. But they gave it to me. But I'm almost saying that was the easiest part because I didn't talk to my wife. I had the sales right and I made that decision to go to Turkey, but I didn't talk to my wife. You don't know my wife. My wife is a lawyer. Also a lawyer. She's a tough lady, a very good lady, tough lady. But letting her accepting something is just jumping in the edges is easier. But I went to home. I recognize some women of that caliber. It's a tough lady. But I went to home and I said very passionately to my wife, this is my dream. We have to do this. We have to go to Turkey. We have to build a new company in Turkey. This is our dream. And I thought, okay, there is the boxing ball, and she will punish me. He said, okay, just do it. I said, wow, what a reasonable wife. Never expected that. I said, without me. I said, what? No, you can go. If you want to explore your life, but you go to Turkey, I will stay here, and if you are successful, I will come over. That's very reasonable. I will not go over there, because she was also with a concept raised in Holland of Turkey. I was also raised because it doesn't matter if we are coming from Turkey or if I'm coming from Turkey, because we had a talk outside about the history of Turkey, what has been taught at schools of the history of Turkey. It's teach nothing. During my whole life, it was said to me, it is bad to have double cultural luggage, it's bad to have two nationalities, it's bad to have diversity. Whole life, they said it, they are saying to you. But now, in my business life, I learned that's an extra thing that you have to, it's gold what we have. It's really gold. Because I saw it when I was working with Baan first. It was an international environment, 60 countries, we had international meetings. It was a very good example. And at the international meetings, around 60 to 70 countries, the general manager of those countries came into Holland. You saw at dinners, you saw blocks. You had the German block. You had Germany, general manager of Germany, Austria, Switzerland, and some small other countries. They were sitting together. You had the Mediterranean block. France, Italy, Greece, Portugal, they were sitting together. You had the English bloc, the UK, the American, they were sitting together. And only me, it's not about me, I was jumping from bloc to bloc. I liked that. Because I was, well, because I could talk with the Germans, I know the hierarchical, the hierarchy, and also the respect that you have to be shown, because one person is talking, not the rest. But also the Mediterranean, I was very good friends with the Greek ones, with the French, and also with the UK. And then it was on my image, it was not an imagination, the double luggage I had, it was an advantage. Let's use it. Okay. Then I started my own company in Turkey. I really didn't know Turkey. But I saw Turkey changing from 94 to 2013 now. I'm always 19 years doing business in Turkey. I was, at that time, I was 25 when I was in Turkey. I started my company. And Turkey at that moment was not self-confident, like now. It was, I don't say it was poor, but it was not external oriented. It didn't have some sort of confidence in itself. There were a lot of political issues. And it was not a very, very positive environment, but still, I was very passionate to do it. And I did it. But one of my first experiences was also very nice. I thought I was speaking Turkish very well. And the first presentation was at Otosan. Otosan is Fort Turkey. It was the whole board of them. And I gave it my best Turkish. I gave the presentation. 10 minutes later, one of the IT directors came to me. I was really trying to explain everything. He said to my ear, "Atilla, we all know English. Just please, just continue in English. You are going to harm yourself. We don't understand anymore." Lesson one, speak the language, native language, very, very well. Lesson two, what I really learned, not each Turk is an entrepreneur. And not each Turk which is living in Holland is a Turkey expert. We are not. Don't pretend that. I see it now also. There are a lot of advisory companies, etc. But what I saw there, it was the dynamics of Turkey where we were very, very, very successful. But after 3 years, I had my first, deception. Because I was in an IT company, at those time IT companies you got, on the one hand you get a lot of higher salary, but also an option plan. And that option plan was taking you to the company. I had an option plan of Baan with seven zeros. It was around $10 to $12 million in 95. That's a lot less of money. But in 99, I was very successful. 99, I had my first personal bankruptcy because they cheated on me. They played a game, you could say, that at the end of 99, the options were not any value anymore. Well, the first thing I said, well, you can be very sad. You can go and cry in the corner, but you can also say, I'm stepping up again, and I'm doing myself a new story. In 99, I came back to Holland, with the idea of, well, Holland is my one of my country bases, because I'm in network here. I came back. I wanted to start again, because I wanted to go back to Turkey. Because I saw the strength of the bridge, the eagerness of the persons working over there. It's not about, if I'm comparing, it's not about good or bad. It's different.